For those of you who doubt the symbolism of the heads on the third beast representing world empires, let us go to Revelation 17 chapter 3rd verse, which states, "There I saw a woman sitting on a scarlet beast that was covered with blasphemous names and had 7 heads and 10 horns." Later on in Revelation 17 chapter verses 9 and 10 it states, "The 7 heads are the 7 hills on which the woman sits. They are also 7 kings. 5 have fallen, 1 is, the other is yet to come." In this reference, the 6th world empire is ruling the nations. The harlot who rides the beast is the revised Roman Empire. Babylon is the code name for Rome as used by the early church leaders, and its city is surrounded by 7 hills. Many may argue that Rome is too weak to rise to power in these end times, but the Bible says what it clearly says. Consider that the largest banks in the world come from Europe. Also, one must remember the Vatican is the richest and most influential religious system in the world. After a major Middle East war and subsequent world war, the power systems of this world will drastically change. My DVD on Daniel's Last Vision discusses this imminent Middle East war and how it will usher in the tribulation period. The 6th world empire, or the revised Roman Empire that comes after this major Middle East war, will be followed by a 7th kingdom that will last but a short time, as described in Revelation 17th chapter verses 11 and 12. The 10 horns you saw are the 10 kings who have not yet received a kingdom, but who for 1 hour will receive authority as kings along with the beast. They will have one purpose and will give their power and authority to the beast. The 8th world empire is the 4th beast of Daniel 7th chapter, which we now need to discuss. Daniel 7 verse 7 says, "After that, in my vision at night, I looked, and there before me was a 4th beast, terrifying and frightening and very powerful. It had large iron teeth. It crushed and devoured its victims and trampled underfoot whatever was left. It was different from all the former beasts, and it had 10 horns. This 4th beast appears to be a mix of the worst characteristics of all other beasts combined into one terrifying creature. It crushes its prey like a leopard, it tramples its victims like a bear, it devours its food with teeth like a lion. Because its teeth are like iron, many mistake this creature for the Roman Empire." The 10 horns described on the 4th beast is later explained in Daniel 7 verse 24 as 10 kings, which will come from this kingdom. These kings will likely come from Islamic countries, many from the former Ottoman Empire. Now, China and Russia may also be involved in this alliance. Daniel 7 verse 8 explains a power struggle. "While I was thinking about the horns, there before me was another horn, a little one, which came up among them, and 3 of the first horns were uprooted before it. This horn had eyes like the eyes of a man, and a mouth that spoke boastfully." Daniel 7 verse 24 later explains, "After them another king will arise different from the earlier ones. He will subdue 3 kings. These 3 kings have too much power. They will need to be weakened to facilitate Antichrist's supremacy." The little horn or Antichrist is further discussed in Daniel 11 verse 21. "He will not be given the honor of royalty." That may be why he is first called the little horn, as he will be from humble origins. The Apostle John's perspective on this 4th beast in Daniel is found in Revelation 13 chapter verses 1 and 2. "This beast has 10 horns and resembles a leopard, but has feet like a bear and a mouth like a lion." The same beast is discussed in Revelation 17 chapter verse 3b. "There I saw a woman sitting on a scarlet beast that was covered with blasphemous names and had 7 heads and 10 horns. So this beast and 10 kings were initially supporting the 6th empire or harlot called Babylon or the revised Roman Empire. The 4th beast of Daniel and the beast of Revelation ironically caused the prostitute's destruction. Revelation 17 verse 16 references this destruction as, The beast and the ten horns you saw will hate the prostitute and bring her to ruin and leave her naked. They will eat her flesh and burn her with fire. After Daniel's initial discussion on the fourth beast, Daniel chapter 7 verse 9 and 10 describes what our eyes should be fixed on as the answer to the Antichrist dilemma. As I looked, thrones were set in place, and the Ancient of Days took his seat. His clothing was as white as snow. The hair of his head was white like wool. His throne was flaming with fire, and its wheels were all ablaze. A river of fire was flowing out from before him. Thousands upon thousands attended him. 10,000 stood before him. The court was seated, and the books were opened. His attendants mentioned here are angels. The court is for the righteous judgment of the saints. The Ancient of Days sits on the throne, the glorious day of Christ's return.